Hello everyone and welcome to Saturday Stitching. I decided to record this in a slightly different place today, standing up because I spent a while sitting in the car, 2-hour car rides twice this week to pick up both kids. So I thought I'd stand for a little while, see how I like recording this way. Anyway, this will be a short video just so that I can show you a few things that I finished and that I'm working on. I didn't get much done, so that's why this will be short. Okay, first up, finished objects. The first one, of course, is my Star Trek pot holder. You probably feel like you already saw this as a finished object because it was almost finished. I was about right here when you saw it last week. So you probably feel like you've already seen it, but it is completely finished now. I finished it this week. And it's bigger than I expected, but it's nice and squishy. And it, you know, I feel like it covers my entire hand, you know, so I feel like I won't burn myself when I use it. Okay, the next thing I have, as I said, everything's behind me on my bed, so I'll be reaching around a bit. Next thing I have is a dishcloth. Yes, your basic granny's favorite that I started and finished in the car on Thursday as I was going to pick up one of my daughters. I don't do any of the driving, so I'm free to knit for the 2 hours up and the 2 hours back. I don't always do so because sometimes I'm not feeling well, but I managed to get this done. It's the Red Heart cotton, the Red Heart scrubby cotton that I made for the other dishcloth. And my plan for this week was to knit as many things out of it as I can to try to use up that ball and see how many things I could get out of one ball. But I didn't get much done. So I have two more projects that I plan to use. I still have this much left. It's a little bit loose. It's a little bit floppy, but not much. It still feels like there's a good bit to this. So I have two more projects in mind that I think will probably use this ball up. So hopefully if I get them finished this week, I'll have them to show you next week. Okay. Works in progress. The works that I've talked about from the beginning, the big Afghan projects, still have not been touched. So, but hopefully I will get to those soon and I'll talk to you a little bit about that. Okay, but also on the car ride, because I also want to finish the ball of Lion Brand Kitchen Cotton. Remember I told you my best friend bought this for me 10 years ago to make her a tea cozy, and I never did, so I'm making dishcloths instead. She seemed to really like the dishcloths that I made for her last time. I asked her if she wanted square ones or round ones, because I already made her one round one and that one square one that looks like a washcloth, a traditional washcloth that I showed you. So I asked her if she wanted square or round. She wants square for the rest of them. So this is what I worked on today when we had to go pick up my other daughter, Sydney, at her college. I know it's not much, but it's the pattern that's on the ball band. I know you can't really see it because of the variegation of the yarn, but it's basically knit two rows, then knit one, purl one for two rows, knit two rows, knit one, purl one for two rows. You always knit the first two stitches and knit the last two stitches to give it a nice little border. And then you do that till the cloth is roughly 9x9. So I'm thinking, because this ball still feels like it has a good bit to it left, I'm thinking I can get this one and maybe one other dishcloth out of this. So I'm making this one, which was off of the ball band for this, and there's also a crochet dishcloth that was on the ball band for this. So if I still have enough yarn, I'll do that one as well, and that should finish off this ball. Because I'm seeing her at the end of the month, so I want to be able to give her the rest of her dishcloths. And the only other new thing in progress I have is this. This is the start of the Simply 200 Yards or Left ankle socks for Chloe. She picked this pattern out of several patterns that I showed you because she really likes shorty short socks. She doesn't even like that much of a cuff on them if she can help it. She likes shorty short, like tennis socks. And this pattern was specifically designed for when you have one 50 gram ball of yarn left and of sock yarn left and want something to do with it. So these socks are supposed to be, you're supposed to be able to make a pair of shorty socks out of one ball. So she'll probably get two pairs of shorty socks because I actually have two balls, because before I realized that she only liked shorty socks, I bought two balls to make a full pair of socks with the, you know, 4-inch cuffs that I'm used to making when I've made socks before. So, and literally, I pretty much did this today, an hour before I recorded, so that I could have something to show you. But also that I could, because I'm tired of showing dishcloths all the time. I want to show that I'm actually doing something. That's part of, you guys don't realize this, but that's part of the purpose of these videos. If I make the video and I say to you, I'm going to work on XYZ, then I'm too embarrassed to come back next week and not have worked on XYZ. So then that makes me work on XYZ, you know. And no, knitting is not a punishment or anything. I know it's supposed to be a hobby. It's not a job or whatever. But I suffer from daydreaming about things I want to do and then not actually doing them. So these videos are serving the purpose of kind of pushing me, nudging me a little to do things that I really will regret it if I don't do them. And I always feel better once I do them. It's just getting myself started. So I need some sort of penalty or something, like, you know, I'll be embarrassed if I don't have something to show. That's why I like meeting up with my stitchy pal Libby, but she's been busy a lot lately, of course, because her kids are younger than mine, so we haven't been able to meet up. But being able to meet up with her every week or every other week encourages me, because I'm embarrassed not to have anything to show. So you guys are taking her place right now. So this has many techniques, that several techniques that I've never done before, which I've never done the magic loop. Because I've always knit on DPNs, but I'm trying to learn. I want to learn any technique that will, where I can avoid DPNs. I've got some DPNs in there if I really need to use them, but I just, every time I think of DPNs, I think of the DPN falling out of my stitches, rolling down the aisle of wherever I'm sitting in the movie theater, or getting lost in the car, or falling out of the bag I'm using or whatever, and they just feel too fiddly. So I want to try anything that will help me not have to use DPN. So I'm learning the magic loop. I learned the Judy's cast on, which was pretty simple, and I'm learning to knit toe up, which I've never done before, just because, you know, I liked knitting cuff down, but, you know, toe up sounds fun. Why not? So that's all the new stuff I have. Now, I mentioned that I hope to get to my other bigger projects soon, and that's because I've gone back to my chore box. This is where I make a schedule. I don't always stick with the chore box, but when I feel myself getting a little out of control with chores and different things, I tend to get overwhelmed because it's like I feel everything calling my name. I need to do the laundry. I need to clean the bathroom. I want to get some knitting done. I want to get some reading done. I want to post on my blog. I want to cook. I want to clean out that closet. I want to, you understand, I get overwhelmed by everything and I don't know which thing I need to attack next. So the box helps me because behind each day, I have a certain chore scheduled. I do that chore. Then I feel like, okay, I've done my must-haves for the day. I'm good. Well, also part of that box, I have a chore schedule. I mean, not a chore schedule, but a needlework rotation. And I got this idea from somebody else a long time ago online of just each day of the week schedule. Okay, your knitting time for today, you'll knit for this person or on this project or however you want to configure it. So for today, I have on my list, so like I have a day of the week for each of my kids and my husband. And then on Saturday and Sunday is either, Sunday is gift knitting or charity knitting, which I haven't done much of yet, but I really want to get into. And Saturday is either I knit for myself, or I knit something for the house, like, you know, like pot holders or dishcloths or something like that, or an extra gift charity day, just depending on where I fall. So since today is Saturday, the things that I have on my mind are either to work on the dishcloths, which I've already mentioned, work on using up the scrubby cotton and make the couple household items that I was thinking of making. But also I have two other things that I thought. For gift knitting, I have this yarn. This follows both meanings of gift. This yarn was a gift to me from my kids for Mother's Day. Must have been roughly around 1999. When I was heavily buying pattern books and trying different kinds of knitting and stuff like that. So they thought it would be, my husband and kids thought it would be a good idea to buy me some yarn. So they bought me 4 balls, which they did know you need to get a good quantity. So they got me 4 balls of this Red Heart Symphony, which is now discontinued. But it's 100% acrylic, worsted weight, but it's meant to, I think, like feel like mohair or imitate mohair. I've never really touched real mohair, so I'm not 100% sure, but I think this is what it's supposed to be. I have a swatch that I crocheted up a while. I must have been when I first got the yarn. If you can see, it's, so it shows, you know, like if you tried to do something lacy, it would show a little bit of stitch definition, but you don't want to do anything too defined because it does have a halo to it. I don't know if you can see on that strand right there, but it's kind of fuzzy. So, and what I have4 balls of this in earth brown, which is roughly, where is it? Yes, I can't see. I can't read with my glasses on. I know it's weird. 310 yards per ball, and I have 4 balls, so I have a little over 1,200 yards of this. But when they bought this for me, this was before Ravelry, and I was still kind of new. I mean, I knew how to do the basic knit and purl since I was in elementary school, but actually, you know, more advanced techniques and things like that, I didn't know what to do with this. So it's been sitting since the end of the 90s. So, and then a few years ago, I saw on Ravelry that there were a few women who make these fluffy lap blankets. And the few women who make this fluffy lap blanket, which was designed by Nikki Epstein in her, and it was in this book called, in Melanie Fallick's book, Weekend Knitting. And you can make a lap blanket version or a full size version. But these, the few women who knit this pattern, they knit like 20 of them to like give away at the nursing homes and stuff like that. And apparently they're real popular among the little old ladies or aunties or whoever they give them to. So I thought this would be a good thing for me to make. Now I have, it's, you're supposed to use this and then a contrast color for like, there's like four stockinette stripes that are not big at all. They're like this from what the picture shows. So you need like 130 yards of 50-gram ball. I'm not sure if this is a 50-gram ball because this has been sitting in my stash for a long time. I don't even know why I have this because generally I don't use brown. But the color, I don't know if you can tell because I know my camera's not good at showing color, but the color of the earth brown here and this brown super saver from Red Heart seems to go together pretty well. So I thought I would, I've been dying to try this pattern for ages, but I just never got around to buying a contrast color that would go good with this. But I guess I'm going to play yarn chicken again and see if I can get a lap blanket. I have enough to make four lap blankets. So if I get at least one lap blanket made, then I need to buy three more contrast colors. Then I can make the other three lap blankets. And my idea is my husband still has four aunties living, and they all live in this area. So that might make a nice Christmas gift. But I don't want to, because as soon as I tell him, oh, I'll make all four of these blankets for them for Christmas, then the minute I say that is the minute I won't want to do it, and then I won't get it done because I'm contrary like that. So right now I'm excited about trying this, so I want to try this pattern. The other thought I had, so I had one home deck thought, one gift thought. The last thought was to knit for myself. Okay, now I started this pattern. This is the Lane Splitter from Knitty. You can see Knitty. You see the skirt. This is a free pattern. I printed this out. I don't remember. I think it's, it says issue, the fall issue. I don't know if it's the 10th fall issue or the fall issue of 2010 of Knitty that this came from. But you search Lane Splitter, you'll find it on Ravelry. But I printed this out in September of 2011, which if you know my family, that was around the time that my husband's mother died. So I never finished this skirt. This is how much I have of it. So not even half, because I was trying to knit a 4X, so not even half. And to be quite honest, I don't even have enough yarn. I don't know what I was thinking. Back then, it feels like that just recently I started noticing yardage in patterns. I know that's crazy. But I know I used to always pay attention to, oh, is it worsted weight or is it fingering weight? But for some reason, I feel like I never paid attention to yardage until the last 6 months, where I'm actively diving back into my stash and trying to figure out how to use up the little bit of yarn that I have. And so I have three skeins of that watercolor. That's Red Heart Super Saver in a variegated yarn called Watercolor. Yes, the ball band is ripped because it's been carted back and forth between the house and the shed a million times because I keep saying I'm going to use this. So I really like the color of it. That's why I bought it. But I'm not sure that I want it in a skirt anymore. And I only bought 720 yards of it. I'm sure when I bought it, I didn't look at the yardage because I almost always back then used Red Heart Super Saver, which is a no-dye lot yarn. So I never thought about having enough yardage. I always thought about how much money do I have? I can afford to buy three of these skeins now. I will come back later and buy more because it's a no-dye lot yarn. That's the whole reason I go with no-dye lot, because I don't usually have enough money to do it all at once. So that skirt in my size would take roughly 1,000, 1,100 yards, and I have about 720. So I'd have to go back and buy more yarn anyway. I'm not sure that I want a skirt, or maybe I'll make the, and I just realized that pattern called for contrast, and I never bought the contrast color, and I'm thinking, why, now looking at the pattern, I'm like, why did I not buy a contrast color? What was I thinking? I don't understand. So I still have the pattern printed out, so maybe I'll make it another time, or maybe I'll make it for one of my girls or something, but I don't think I'm gonna make it for myself anytime soon. But what I do currently want for myself is a shawl. And I don't mind, I know a lot of people say Red Heart Super Saver is rough. I don't mind a shawl being a little bit rough. I just want something to wrap around my shoulders. When I say shawl, I mean around my shoulders, not around my neck, like all the trendy knitters and crocheters are doing right now. I want to be an old lady and wrap it around my shoulders so that I can ward off the chill from the air conditioning when I go in stores during the summer, or when I go over to a friend's house during the summer. I wanted to have something like that. So I thought maybe I could find a pattern, a shawl pattern, to go with this yarn. So those are my three choices for what I'm going to do today. I don't know which one I'm going to go with. I guess I'll let you know next week which one I decided to go with. Okay, that's all. I'm at 22 minutes. That is all the crafty stuff I'm going to talk about. So if you came here just for the crafty stuff, bye. I'm only going to do a little bit of chitty chatty here at the end, because both of my girls are here with me. I shouldn't say both of my girls, because I know my eldest, my number one, my firstborn, is probably going to watch this and go, hey, what about me? But yes, we went and picked up one twin from her college in that direction, and then went and picked up the other twin from her college in that direction. So they're both home now, and we stopped on the way to see my eldest, my number one, my Maya. And while we were there, she gave me this. I don't know if you can see it. Let me see if I can position my hand well enough. This is my very first henna tattoo. I don't have any permanent tattoos, but I am really loving this henna. Which is very strange, because I don't wear makeup. I rarely paint. I mean, I wear makeup occasionally. You've seen me on here with lipstick before. You know, and if I'm really feeling fancy, I'll put on some eyeliner and some mascara. But generally, most days, I am, you know, if I leave the house, I'll put some lip gloss on and that's it. So I don't wear makeup. I rarely wear jewelry. I don't even really own any jewelry very much that I like. I don't paint my nails. You know, I don't do, pulling my hand in the wrong direction. Sorry about that. So I don't do any of the fancy schmancy stuff, but this henna makes me feel elegant. It makes me feel swelligant. I like the way it looks on my skin. So, I'll get to look at it and admire it for a week. and appreciate my daughter's handiwork. I never knew that she had an artistic bent, and I am just, I look at it amazed at how pretty it is and amazed at how skilled she is. I'm just proud of her. I'm just proud of her. So that's all the chatty stuff I have to talk about. If I get my act together, I might do a Friday Reads next Friday. I know I keep threatening to do it, and one of these days I'll get that started. But if I don't get my act together, then you'll see me here next Saturday for Saturday Stitching. Bye.